Ever wonder what fire is? What's a flame? Why it looks the way it does? I'll answer these questions using this candle flame as an example. This candle has a wick that's embedded in wax. The wick burns slowly, but it's mainly the wax that's the fuel. Let's look at it more closely. The wax is largely made up of carbon and hydrogen atoms bonded together into large hydrocarbon molecules. To start the fire going, we apply heat. When we do, that causes the molecules to move around vigorously, breaking the wax molecules into individual carbon and hydrogen atoms. These individual atoms are no longer part of a solid structure, but are now a gas. This process is called pyrolysis. Next, these atoms, still moving around vigorously due to the heat, collide with oxygen atoms in the air. When they do, they give off bluish light. This is the bluish color you see at the base of the flame. This process is called chemiluminescence. The oxygen atoms also bond with the hydrogen and carbon atoms to form new molecules, such as water with two hydrogens and an oxygen, and carbon dioxide with one carbon and two oxygens. When they do bond, energy is released in the form of more heat. This is called oxidation. In some fires, such as candle fires, there are a lot of extra carbon atoms left over. These carbon atoms combine together to form soot. The heat heats up the soot, and when it reaches certain temperature ranges, it glows with visible light, and with a candle flame, mostly yellowish light. At the tip of the yellowish flame, the temperature reaches around 1200 degrees Celsius, or 2200 Fahrenheit. This process is called incandescence. As to why a flame has the shape it does, that's because hot air rises upward. In this case, it's the air surrounding the flame that's being heated and rises up. When it does, cool air rushes in to replace it, and that cool air also heats up and rises. This continual cycle is called convection, and it's this that corrals the flame into its teardrop shape. As an interesting side note, heat rises like this only in a gravity environment. When a flame burns in an environment with little or no gravity, as was done in experiments in the space shuttle, the flame is more spherical in shape, since there is no up. Well, thanks for watching. Check out my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more videos like this. That includes one explaining hot, neutral, and ground, and why our power outlets have such strange shapes, one on how nuclear fusion works in the sun, and one on how fast electrons and electricity move in a wire. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, or leave a question or comment below. See you soon!